Earlier this evening, the Canadian Football League draft began, and we're making our way through the 8 rounds. Zach Keenan joins us live from Herb Parker Stadium. And Zach, I understand some good news just came in for one Minot State football player, hey?
Some great news. Just about 2 minutes ago, Troy Cowell was drafted in the final round by the BC Lions. Troy Cowell, professional football player. How does that sound?
It's kind of wild. I mean, 6 years of college football, now you get to go play again. It's an awesome experience, but it's kind of crazy to hear that you're a pro now. So excited for the opportunity, though. So
this draft started 3.5, almost 4 hours ago. We've still got a full room behind us of Troy's friends, family, teammates, everyone. How meaningful is it to have everyone here to support?
A lot. It means a lot that they'll come out tonight. This is Tuesday night, so I know it's a little late right now, but I'm glad they'll come out the week before finals, and I'm glad my family got to come down and watch. And it was just a great night and a great day, so I'm just thankful.
From High River, Alberta, to Minot, North Dakota, to British Columbia, how you feeling right now, man?
I'm excited. I mean, I'm excited to get to camp next week and get to work and see what I can do out there and make a run of the Grey Cup next year with BC.
How are you guys feeling right now?
Yeah!
Congratulations to Troy Cowell, BC Lion. I'll see you later. Back at you in the studio, Joe.
Oh, what a great night for him. All right, thank you so much, Zach. Well, today felt like a perfect day for some baseball, and there was a whole lot of it. Now that we're less than a month away from the state tournament, you would hope we have games. First up, Berthold hosting DeLax Burlington. Lakers have runners on the corners, and the ball hit to at third base. Force out at second gets the Bombers out of the inning. DLB up 5-0, but Berthold loads up the bases in the third. Rylan Olson on the mound. The ball is going to be chopped to Carson Yale at first base, touches the bag, and keeps the lead without a run crossing. Lakers did damage in the fourth. Braylon Fisher at the plate hits into center field, brings home Ty Hughes from second base. After a two-out rally, a strikeout closes out the inning on the mound for the Bombers. Rylan Olson picked up the win on the mound for DLB. He also hit a home run and a triple. Now the Lakers shut out the Bombers in game two to complete the sweep. Over in Surrey, the Bishop Ryan Lions are on a 5-game win streak. Only team they've lost to is Surrey. Bottom of the sixth, Jet Lundeen pitching for Ryan. Fly ball hit to Colton Feller in left field. Feller holds on, and the Lions lead by one run going into the seventh. Ryan puts a runner on first, not in Colton France's watch. The pickoff move to Porter Jung at first. Jung hits the tag. Still a one-run lead for Ryan. Surrey loads the bases. And Andrew Eby, not that way, the other way. Two runs score, and the Mustangs walk off their home field with a win. Colton Francis picks up the win in relief. Eby gets the credit for the walk-off.
I mean, it feels pretty good. I mean, we didn't really play our best game, but, I mean, a win's a win. I think we got good momentum. I think we're going to finish strong.
Now, they finished strong, all right. The Bats ignited in game two for a big Mustangs win. Now, time now for trivia. When was the last time a Beavers player was drafted into the CFL? They've had a few players, but none drafted since this year. It was Dexter Ross, an All-American defensive end. The Beavers were still in the NAIA. Mike Sivertson was the head coach at the time. He was drafted by the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. Now, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers picked him in the 2006 draft. We'll be right back.